God's morning, Corona. It is indeed an honor and a privilege to come to you. I thought it would be appropriate to give you a word of encouragement during this time of distress. Certainly, we're living in a time of uncertainty, insecurity, and it seems instability. But it depends on your perspective, and I want us to remember that as children of God, it is a time of certainty, a time of stability, and a time of security because God is still sovereign and he is still on the throne. So I want to give us a word this morning that I think that will help us to remember God's word to help us during this season of distress. The psalmist says in Psalms 50 and verse number 14, he says, "Sacrifice thank offerings to God. Fulfill your vows to the Most High and call upon me in the day of trouble. I will deliver you and you will honor me." He says, call on me in the day of trouble. I will deliver you and you will honor me. Certainly, this is a time that we want to honor God, even in the midst of the chaos, even in the midst of the distress, even in the midst of uncertainty, we can still serve and display a faith in God that will help us to manage these difficult times. Did you know that you bring glory to God by calling upon him when you are in distress? That's right. We bring glory to God when we call on him when we are in distress. God promises that he will deliver us if we turn to him. So I want us to remember that one of the best ways to face challenges is to look to the unchanging God. We face our challenges of life by looking to the unchanging God because he is always sovereign, he is always stable, he is always secure. He has never rocked by anything that happens in our lives. So the situations and circumstances, COVID-19, we have nothing to fear when we have feared God himself. Fear is only false evidence that's appearing to be real. Yes, the evidence seems to be real, but at the same time, I want to say that it is not real when we look at who holds this world in the hollow of his hands. This world is not to control us, the situations and circumstances, but instead we are to trust God. And so that's what I want to challenge us with. There are many times when God allows us to reach a point of need in order that he might get our attention so that we can call upon him and we let him demonstrate to the world that is watching around us the difference that he makes in the life of a child of God. And I believe it is our time as children of God to allow God's light to shine. If you will notice, my shirt is designed by a young man named CJ Cordell Brandon Jr. It's YOGOCAL, based on Philippians 4:4. And what that really means is that you only get one chance at life. You only get one chance at life. And this is our chance to make the best of this life. We know that life will be filled with ups and downs, but we know that God can get us around and get us through anything that we go through. So for the children of God, I want to remind us that God allows us to experience what goes on in our world, but he never intends for those experiences to control us. Instead, he expects us to cry out to him. Because see, if we never faced a challenge, we would become self-sufficient and perhaps proud that we can handle life on our own. But with this challenge, remember what the psalmist says. Call on me in the day of trouble. That is the day of distress. That is what we're faced with. But remember the promise of God. I will deliver you. God promises that he will deliver us. And if God promises to deliver us, we have no reason to fear, but we have every reason to faith. So we must trust faith instead of fear so that we can eliminate the fears and build our faith. We must build ourselves up on the most holy faith. This is a time to turn to the Word of God instead of the worries of the world. Please don't get caught up in listening to all the news that gives us weird words instead of wise words, worrisome words instead of wholesome words. We live in a world that stands in need of wise words for weird worry in this wacky world. So remember Psalms 50, verse 14 through 15, with these last thoughts. Call on me in the day of distress, the day of trouble. I will deliver you, and you will honor me. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we want to honor you with our lives. We don't want to get caught up and be horrified by COVID-19. Father, we want to be cautious. We want to take precautionary measures. But Father, more than anything else, we want to be totally dependent on you. Thank you for helping us to cry out to you daily. Because if we talk to you daily, dear Father, you've promised in your word that you would strengthen us if we would use our prayer power. So instead of us worrying, help us to remember that we are to be anxious for nothing. But in everything by prayer and supplication, we are to present our requests to you, Heavenly Father. And you promise to give us peace, to give us rest that only you can supply. It's in Jesus' name that we offer this prayer on behalf of all, dear Father. May your peace that passes all understanding be ours, and may we share it with others in such a disturbed time. It's in Jesus' name we pray and thank you. Amen.